Hello, and welcome back to another edition of the Medik Trust plugin. Today I'm going to show you guys a little bit of what's been going on with the new asymmetric gable rafter roofs that I've just recently added. So what I've done is I've gone ahead and created this simple gable roof, I guess, and I put it on just a little kind of a transparent block here so we can just see and visualize better what's happening with the roof itself, rather than focus on other details. So I'm going to go ahead and turn off the roof cladding and the roof sheathing right now, and just so we can see what's going on under the hood a little bit. So let's turn off our roof sheathing as well. Okay, so now we've got the rafters here. Okay, so pretty basic. We've got a ridge board, rafters. We've got some structural outlookers, of course. So when you first go to create the roof, it will actually prompt you, if you want to use a symmetric or an asymmetric roof. But right now we're just going to hop right into the edit menu. So to edit this roof, we just right click on it and edit rafter assembly. Okay, so the first thing you're going to notice, of course, is this menu is quite large. There's a lot of parameters. That's to be expected. But, we try to organize it as best we can so it's not too overwhelming. So kind of your basic options are in the first block of stuff here, and then you've got your advanced options here. Okay, so the first thing you'll notice is right here at the top we have now a roof type. So before that was not there, and it allows you to switch from a symmetric gable to an asymmetric gable. So let's go ahead and change that to asymmetric gable. Now when we do that, you'll notice that we had another little bunch of parameters, four parameters to be exact, pop up. So what that will give you now is the ability to set the right side of the roof. So the A side is always the left side, and the B is always the right side of the roof. So we're going to change, let's see, right now we've got the A side set with our pitch here is 812. And let's go ahead and set this to 412 on the right side. Okay, and of course nothing happens until we hit update. So we're going to take these parameters here and just change them up a little bit. We've got 9.5 on the rafter depth. We'll keep the rafter depth the same. And bird's mouth cut. And of course, we can set a separate bird's mouth cut here that's independent of this bird's mouth cut on the left side. But for now, we've got a 3.5. Let's go. Let's do 5.5, and let's leave this at 0 on the delta height. I'm going to explain this in just a second. So let's go ahead and update. Okay, so now you can see what's happened is, and notice we've also enabled our ceiling joists. So we're still drawing ceiling joists, but of course, things happen a little differently when you've got an asymmetric roof. You notice the way it's cut off here. This ceiling joist, by the way, is raised up, I think. Let's see here. Where's our ceiling joist options? Ceiling joist options are right. I can never find half the stuff myself. Yes, right there. Okay, with the ceiling joist height, so they're 6 inches off the top plate here. And of course, we could drop that down to 0 if we want. Let's do that. It's easily enough done, and you can see what happens to the boards as we do that. It doesn't trim or truncate off the corner. So basically, now what we have is an asymmetric roof. So we've got a pitch here of 812 and a pitch of 412 on this side. And notice that the plugin automatically calculates, where to put that peak, where to drop everything. And you can see we've got our bird's mouth cut there, and we've got our bird's mouth cut here, 5.5. So we've got a 3.5 on this side. And, you may want to have a different bird's mouth cut, you may not, but that's all up to you. And so because these are shorter, let's go ahead and drop this down to a 12-12. I'm going to change that. And you can see that, this rafter is pretty short, so we don't need that quite that long or deep. So let's go ahead and make that a 2x8. So I'm going to change that to 7.25. Hit update again. Okay, now you can see that we've got a 9.5-inch rafter on this side, and we've got a 7.5-inch on this side. And so the nice thing is with this whole parametric ability, the ability to edit these roofs, we can sit here and play with this all day long and fine-tune it, get it to whatever we want. And you can see that the labels, of course, are landing all in the right spots where they should be. We've got structural outlookers. We've got a custom what I call a custom gable rafter along the sides here on the gable ends. So now it's going to get even more interesting. So we've got basically, you know, this kind of shape, and you know, it doesn't have to be this way. You could change this 412 and make this maybe 1012, and let's hit the update on that. Okay, and so now it's going that way. The thing to note though is that this side is always what I call the B side or the right side, and we have this what I call this delta height variable. And so what this does is it allows us to move the bearing height of this side up or down, depending on what we want to do. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and let's switch this back 12 4 12, and I'm going to bump this up to 6 inches. So what that's going to do is it's going to bump this up relative to the left side. It's going to bump this up 6 inches higher. Let's go ahead and update that. Okay, so now what's happening, and you can see, let's see, zoom in here a little bit. What you've got is, you know, you've got a 6-inch height difference here. So if your top plate on this wall is 6 inches higher, or 12 inches, or whatever it happens to be, let's go ahead and 12 inches on that, see what happens. Okay, then you can account for that. Now, one thing to note is if you do have ceiling joist enabled, when you go to a non-zero delta height, I am currently disabling the ceiling joist because I'm not sure what exactly to do with those yet. In other words, if I had them enabled, you know, you'd have ceiling joist coming here. Let's assume, of course, that the ceiling joist height is right on the top of the top plate. Then you'd have ceiling joist coming in at this height. So, you know, they wouldn't match. And so, again, I'm waiting for a little more input from users on how they want me to handle that, and then I'll go ahead and add that back in. But for now, if you do have a delta height difference, then the ceiling joist will automatically be disabled. And the other cool thing, too, is you can change this height to a negative height. So let's go ahead and minus 12 inches on that. And you'll notice that it drops it down 12 inches below the height of the left side. So, you know, you got a few options here, what you can do with a asymmetric roof. It's quite flexible that way. Basically, all of the regular options, the gutters, the ridge cap, all that, hip and ridge, is all steel enabled, and structural outlookers, everything is there. I'm going to go ahead and turn back on now the roof sheeting layer, and you can see that, you know, everything matches up as it should. Let's go ahead and turn on the cladding layer. Okay, and you can see that with an asymmetric roof, the hip and ridge here is a little bit interesting. So, you know, it kind of beat me up a little bit here trying to figure out all this math to make sure these things worked out exactly right, but I think we finally got it now. And so you can see that your hip and ridge is all set up nice, and you have the ability to create asymmetric roofs. If there's any other questions on this, please let me know, but that's pretty much it. And like I said, as you switch between asymmetric to symmetric, you will get these additional 4 parameters that can allow you to essentially configure the right side of the roof. So now let's say, for instance, you know, you want that 12-12 roof, or whatever it is, let's go back to 8-12 for instance, and maybe we want to move it back to a symmetric roof. Okay, notice that goes away, we hit update. Okay, now you're back to your regular old gable roof. And you know, you can always switch it back and forth. The nice thing about this is it doesn't really matter. You can change things up. I think we should be good as far as the metric version goes. I did take care of a few issues with that. There always is a few more issues as far as, you know, I need to add in a few more items. Not really issues, I suppose, but I need to add in some the hurricane ties here, like I have for trusses and stuff. So there's always more stuff to do. You'll notice, too, that I also have a soffit cut set up here on these rafters because they're quite deep, and right here as well. But the soffit cut, I haven't set that independently, so basically if you do a half-inch soffit cut here, it's going to also do a half-inch soffit cut on the other side as well. And of course that's independent of your overhangs and everything else. So anyways, I appreciate you guys' support, and if you have any other questions, please feel free to give me a call. Thank you very much.